Good Saturday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek down here in the lower right-hand or lower left-hand, left, right, somewhere in there. You'll figure it out. At this point in time, again, pretty quiet in the Mid-South area, and we'll continue again to see the potential for more in the way of quiet conditions now. Tomorrow may be a little different out there as we see more chances of showers and thunderstorms into parts of the Mid-South area. We continue again to see the possibility of some more heat and humidity today. Not really seeing, again, a lot of activity throughout the course of the rest of the next couple of days. So again, after that, things are going to be looking very quiet, again, very dry as well as we get into fire season in Tennessee, which starts basically tomorrow. You're going to need a permit to burn stuff in certain locations, so please keep that in mind if you're going to be doing anything involving fire or flame outside, whether it's burning rubbish off and anything in the way of leftover leaves and yard waste. It's very dry out there and could be a bit of a problem into the course of the next couple of days. We'll take a look and see what's going on with burn conditions in the Mid-South area coming up here in just a little bit, so stay tuned for more on that. We continue again to see the potential of some quiet conditions for in the Mid-South right now, but once again, things may be changing by just a little bit as we head into the course of the next couple of days, so stay tuned for more there. Welcoming in all of our Facebook viewers. Thanks to everybody for stopping on by, and thanks to everybody who's signing in on Periscope and Twitter for this morning. This is our live video weather feed, video weather blog at just past about 8 o'clock on Saturday morning. Questions, concerns, ideas, drop them into the comments section. We'd love to have you along for the ride to keep up to date with what's going on with weather in the Mid-South area as we take a look around the Mid-South. Currently in Germantown from the City Hall camera high atop the taller water tower just north of Germantown High School and looking off toward the area around close to Poplar and Mendenhall where the towers are located. Again, decently quiet for right now. Little haze around the horizon, but otherwise not doing too bad out there. Rainfall, nothing to see at this point in time. Things are very quiet and will continue to be so throughout the rest of the day and into the rest of the afternoon and evening. Now, tomorrow, more chances of rain. Not great, but we will see more chances of activity heading our direction into the course of the next day or so as a new cold front starts to make its way through the area. We'll talk more about that coming up. Sorry about that. Need to stabilize my microphone a little bit better. Rest of the day, again, showing the possibility of some more problems, again, with possibilities of showers and thunderstorms, just not seeing that going on here. Let's take a look and see what's going on the pages out there from around the area of Mississippi's Forestry Commission. Again, we keep an eye on burn bans and things of that nature going on. We don't have anything in the way of burn bans from what it looks like right now. Let me double check this real quick. No burn bans for areas in Mississippi, so good news on that. We'll go to the Arkansas Forestry Commission and show numerous burn bans across much of the state, including Cross County in the News Channel 3 viewing area under a burn ban at this time, and numerous other counties under burn bans at this point. That's in effect until further notice. For Tennessee, we don't have any burn bans issued specifically. We may see them happen a little bit later on, depending on how bad things get, but the Tennessee Bureau of Forestry does not issue a burn ban unless it's absolutely necessary. You do need a burn permit starting tomorrow, October 15th. That marks the beginning of wildfire season. If you'd like to see more about this, go to burnsafetn.org. Crystal Smith Walton, thank you very much for joining us from South Haven this morning. And Betty Sue Gregg from Enid, Mississippi, thank you very much for tuning into the show so far. So again, burning in the Mid-South area, we're just not seeing a lot going on at this point in time. We're going to continue again to see some pretty dry conditions out there. And it looks like the drought monitor has moved their pages yet again. Not seeing huge amounts of drought problems out there, but again, it is some abnormally dry conditions into parts of Mississippi and into and around areas of eastern Oklahoma, northeast Texas, and back into Arkansas. A little bit more dry conditions back toward the Washtenaws and the Boston Mountains, and that's about as bad as it gets there. So not as bad as it could be, but not as good as it could be with moisture out across the Mid-South either at this time. Temperatures across the area, again, back in the 60s and 50s. Beautiful view of sunrise light in and around the area. The view from Heidelberg Elementary in Clarksdale looking very nice at this time. We already showed you Germantown. Lots of golfers out on the golf course this morning. from Windy Country Club in southeast Memphis. So everybody out hitting the links early this morning. More of our WeatherBug cameras available at WREG.com/webcams if you'd like to see more about what's going on there. Visibility a little lower in Kennett, Missouri. Got 4 mile visibility reported there. Outside of that, visibility is actually pretty nice across much of the area. 4 mile visibility over toward Maury County in Columbia, Tennessee, and about 5 mile visibility in Haleyville and back toward Decatur in Alabama. We're just not seeing, again, as much as the fog as we saw about 24 hours ago. So that, again, could be something to, again, monitor if you're heading out the door. Temperatures out there this morning, mainly back in the 50s and 60s. Continuing to see, again, some pretty quiet conditions for the morning hours. Could be the possibility of some more showers and thunderstorms popping up into the rest of the day today. So, again, south and east of us, just not that much showing up in the way of rainfall. 70 degrees already at Memphis International Airport. 50s up around portions of Millington and also around Atoka and close to the area around Tipton, Gilt Edge at 59 degrees, 59 as well at the Wolf River Station near Collierville, 59 degrees in Hernando, and 57 in Holly Springs, Mississippi. So quiet and cool enough for a jacket may not be such a bad idea for this morning. Not seeing a lot to change in the near future. The possibility of thunderstorms tomorrow is going to be fairly low. We're just not picking up much of anything in the way of a threat, but for severe weather purposes. But we will be looking at more potential of rainfall as high pressure relents and lets this cold front drop through the area as we go through about midday tomorrow. It's not going to be a major threat, but if you have outdoor plans, again, this is something you're going to need to prepare for. The threat of the chances of showers and thunderstorms will begin in the morning. Let me stop this loop here for a second. Tonight at about 8 p.m., 6, 7, 8 p.m., the front will be northwest of us. By midnight, it'll be starting to move into the mid-south with a few showers east of the front, but pretty dry there. And by tomorrow morning, that front will be sitting right on our doorstep, moving into northeastern parts of Arkansas and the boot heel of Missouri. Chances of rain and thunderstorms, yes. Not great chances, though. And then as we get into tomorrow evening, the front races on through, gives us our chance of rainfall, and then that's it. There's not going to be much of anything else in the way of rain anytime soon. Record high for today is 90 degrees. We may come close to tying or breaking that later on today, believe it or not. Really have to get a better microphone stand. Sorry about that. We see, again, the temperatures again through the rest of the day back into the upper 80s to lower 90s. Lows tonight in the upper 60s to lower 70s. Chances of rain really start to move in as we get into tomorrow morning around daybreak and continue into the rest of the day, overspreading much of the mid-south. Now, the front's going to be coming through by about midday as you see that switch in the lines from the south winds east of the Mississippi to the northwest winds coming in behind that front and could be a little breezy at times, 10 to 15 miles per hour, and temperatures will be much cooler, only back in the lower to mid-70s. Tupelo, Corinth, Oxford, you could make 80 degrees tomorrow, but that's going to be about all that we see out there. Low temperatures Sunday night, 40s across much of the area. Metro should be staying in the lower 50s and should be, again, some very dry conditions out there. Beautiful on Monday, temperatures back into the mid to upper 60s, so pretty quiet, again, for the mid-south area as we go into Monday after all this dry, cool air moves on through. Rest of the week, let me skip ahead to next Friday. Hang on a second. And we'll be warming back up again with numbers back into the mid to upper 70s across much of the area. Next, severe weather spotter training events will be coming up in the near future. Coming up on the 16th of October, that'll be Monday, 6:30 in Lepanto, Arkansas at the fire department at 728 Greenwood. On Tuesday, 6:30 p.m. in Corning, Arkansas, that'll be on Elm Street there at the Ainley Community Center. And a week from Monday in Paris, Tennessee at the Henry County EOC, 204 North Brewer Street in Paris, Tennessee. These meetings teach you what you need to know to get trained for severe weather, and they'll be coming up throughout the next few weeks right into November. We are approaching the second severe weather season of the year from late October through about early December. We can get some pretty nasty weather through here, so it's best to be prepared for it, and this is the best opportunity to do so. If you'd like to know more, again, all you have to do is go to the National Weather Service, click on the Mid-South. Very simple. Go to weather.gov, weather.gov, click on the Mid-South area. That'll take you to the National Weather Service in Memphis, and then click on the headline, become a storm spotter for the fall 2017 training schedule, And there you go. It's that easy. If you haven't seen that before, check out more information on my Facebook page, facebook.com/Austen Onek, WREG. Also on my Twitter page as well, Google+, also on Instagram, keeping track of all sorts of cool pictures out there. And thanks to everybody for sending some of those in, including one from above Music City, a drone picture from last night. Beautiful view showing up there. The tropics continue to be active with Ophelia, a Category 2 hurricane heading for Ireland, and quite possibly a new disturbance right where it's not needed, right around the area of Puerto Rico, just east of there. We'll be watching that throughout the course of the rest of the weekend, so stay tuned for more on that. More on my 7-day forecast available at WREG.com/weather, and we'll have more on your complete forecast throughout the rest of the weekend on the East Arkansas Broadcast Network stations. I got to head back out on set to get ready for the next weather segment. It's almost 8:15, so join me live on air. Nina Harrelson has all the day's news, and Glenn Carver has an update on last night's Friday Night Football scores, so stay tuned for more there. Live and direct throughout the rest of the weekend, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned to News Channel 3 on air and online.